Georges Le Chevalier had his first major solo exhibition 15 years ago. Since then, his paintings, photographic works, and public art installations have been exhibited extensively, nationally and internationally, in distinguished galleries and museums. Le Chevalier has over 10 years of bilingual teaching experience at different museum educational departments, correctional facilities, and at the elementary, high school, and university levels.
I do come from a family of artists and painters. The father of my grandmother, his name was Joseph Leeds, and he was a painter around the turn of the century in Milan, Italy. The cousin of my grandfather, Jacques Le Chevalier, he was a stained glass window maker, and one of the most famous ones at best in France. He was commissioned to create the stained glass windows in Notre Dame Cathedral in Paris. My cousin Cécile Le Chevalier Page, she's a sculptor in Paris right now. Her work has been exhibited throughout Europe.
The youngest son of a French father and a Puerto Rican mother, Georges Patrick Le Chevalier Marrero was born in Paris, France on February 8, 1966. Shortly after, his family moved to San Juan, Puerto Rico, where he grew up speaking Spanish.
I did grow up there, and it was a great childhood just because of the weather, being outside all the time playing. And we did go back to France every summer. They would send me to the northeast region of France in Alsace-Lorraine, a city called Nancy, and that's where I did spend my summers growing up.
At the age of 13, Le Chevalier's family moved to Los Angeles, California, where he added a third language and culture to his repertoire and discovered his fascination towards art.
I was doing at the time a lot of figurative and landscape paintings. I really wanted to get my strength from the classics. And the funny part, when I was doing abstract art in Spain, I would turn around and use colors that I was familiar with in California. In Chile, what I did was an outside installation called Carretas, which means carts. It was a small town where at one point it became very famous for the wheel carts that they create in the town. And now it's a symbol of the old city. What I wanted to do, I wanted to bring this symbol into the 21st century. And what I did digital drawings that we printed in vinyl. And once in Chile, we took the old ways of using eucalyptus tree and mounted the computer-generated drawings in the desert. While in Hungary, I stayed in Balaton Fured, which was a small city outside of Lake Balaton. I did do a series of paintings, and I did create a public artwork called Kérdőjel, which means question mark in Hungarian. The paintings I created one painting a day while I was there. And I'm very involved in language, and what I did, I wrote a lot of Hungarian words and dates and places in the paintings, kind of like a journal to keep track of these 15 days that I spent there. What I'm trying to do with the question marks are public installations across the whole world, and what I want to do is I want to get a reaction from people, because for me, the artist is the one who ask the questions, would try to make people think. The idea for the Cup Parade came just because I'm very involved in tattoos and I love tattoos, and I thought it would be great to have a tattooed cow. You don't expect a cow to be tattooed, and I wanted her to be a little rebellious, a little pissed off. Right now, me and my wife, we're in the process of adopting two babies. My son's name is Diego Zinedine, and my daughter's Lola Nadine. So I'm really excited about the future. I love where I am right now in life. I have my studio, I have a lovely wife. I have babies that will be here very soon.